Hey guys, so we all know about the PlayStation Network, or maybe you don't know about the PlayStation Network, and now you're gonna learn about it. The PlayStation Network is basically how Sony does all their shit. That's the network you play on. That's where they host a bunch of games, and on it they have something called PlayStation Plus. And this video is gonna be about PlayStation Plus, and mostly praising PlayStation Plus. Essentially, what it is you pay. For 3 months, it's $20, or for a year, it's $50, which is still less than a game when it's new. So, essentially, if you pay for 3 months, it's $6 a month, basically, and 1 year is about $4 a month. Now, why get PlayStation Plus? Why is PlayStation Plus worth paying anything for when you get the online service for free? Because you get a lot of free shit with PlayStation Plus. One thing that's big is they give you free games every month. And I'm not talking about like shitty indie games like you'll see every day on sale on Steam. I mean actual blockbuster titles for free. Just this month, it's what month is it? It's July 2012. Infamous 2, $40. $40 retail, free. Little Big Planet 2, one of PlayStation's best-selling titles, $40. Free. Gotham City Impostors just came out free. Renegade Ops, free. Pac-Man, some Championship Edition, free. Warhammer Space Marine, a $40 game, which I bought for $20 and it's really fun, free. Choplifter, some indie game, that's free. Saints Row 2, free. Just Cause 2, free. Ratchet and Clank All for One literally just came out. It's $60, free. The Lara Croft Guardian of Light, free, and some Sideway New York game, free. Those games added up together are $286. $286. And you paid $6 for PlayStation Plus every month. If you get it for 3 months, if you get it for a year, it's only $4. All those games free. Free. Well, no, they're $4. All those games $4. $4. For $4. And you get basically, let's round it off, it's $300 worth of games for $4. And you might be thinking, oh, well, you're only allowed to download it once and next month you won't be able to get it. No. Just like Steam, it's tied in to your PlayStation Network account. So my PlayStation account is I think it's a BC Force. So if I went on PlayStation Plus, I gave them the 'cause you can buy the PlayStation Plus cards, or you could buy the cards for PlayStation Plus with money on it to play on the PlayStation Network store. If I give that in and I get however long, I can get all these games tied into my account. So whenever I am, wherever I am, whatever PS3 I'm on, wherever, as long as I'm on my account, I can go onto it, download all or any of these games, and play them. But that's not all PlayStation Plus gives you. As I found out, it actually gives you exclusive like betas and demos. Like you'll get pretty much into every beta, obviously for free. It's a beta; you don't pay for betas. You get into all the betas. You get exclusive demos for games that haven't. Demos are planned to be released next week, but if you're PlayStation Plus, you get them a week early, which is pretty cool. And you get like I said, all the free games, but you get 150 megabytes of online storage, or I think it's 250 or something, essentially just for your saves. So like, PlayStation Plus has a problem with their saves, or PlayStation has a problem with their saves, whereas my friend, he'll be playing Dark Souls, and then or yeah, Dark Souls, and his game got like corrupted or something for some, because the power went out while he was playing. It was a really stupid thing, and then his saves were deleted, and he couldn't back them up because they weren't saved anywhere, because why the fuck would you back up your saves when you assume nothing will happen because you have a hard copy right there on your PlayStation? But no, these automatically will let you update anything you want, upload anything you want, especially your saves to the PlayStation Cloud, and you can always access it even if you don't have PlayStation Plus anymore. But one thing that I was really surprised with is PlayStation Plus actually gives you access to a ginormous list of blockbuster games. And if you don't have them, you can play any game you want, multiplayer or single player, for 1 hour, or you know, straight or segmented up. You can play a game for 1 hour to see if you like it. You just play it. You can play a game for 1 hour. You don't have to buy it. You just have to download it and then play it. It gives you what I was surprised with, it actually gives you 1 hour play times on like almost all their games, like Uncharted, God of War, like games that are specific to that IP. It gives you Mortal Kombat, Saints Row 3, Mass Effect 3, Crysis 2, Battlefield 3, all the Assassin's Creed games. Let you play them for an hour. Just play them. Play them for an hour. If you like it, then you can buy it. And if you buy it, then it saves your progress, unlike demos where it won't save your progress and you have to start all over and play that part of the game again. It saves all your trophies that you would have gotten. I think that's really cool. And if you don't have PlayStation Plus, other games that are on PlayStation Network, they might be like 20 or 30% off, let's say they are. If you have PlayStation Plus, they're like 80% off. So essentially, you're buying a $50 game, and it's now $10. That's pretty sweet. I think that's pretty sweet. That's PlayStation Plus. I think it's amazing that they're doing all this for their customers. I guess they're trying to get more people into PlayStation and try to get them away from Microsoft's Xbox, or they're trying to get more people into their stuff by offering free shit. Well, except it's not really free, but it's so cheap. It's pretty fucking cheap. $50 for 1 year. It comes out to $4 a month. Every month there's a list of games like this that are literally free. Like, I was playing, I checked PlayStation Plus before I go on every month before I play Dark Souls. And, like, 1 month it was all the Prince of Persia games. 1 month it was all the Siphon Filter. 1 month it was all the Devil May Cry games. 1 month it was a bunch of the Final Fantasy games. So, like, games like that go on sale. And it's less of a sale, but more of they're free if you have PlayStation Plus. So $4 a month. And you go, honestly, to me it's free. $4 a month isn't anything. $50 is money, but $4 a month, if you split it up that way, that's borderline fucking free. $4 a month, you can't even buy The Binding of Isaac on PC for $4. Like, that's an indie game. You can't buy that for $4. You're getting all these blockbuster titles, all these games that have ginormous fan following. Like Shadow of Colossus was free, I think, a couple months ago, that's it. Like, you get all this shit for like $4. I just found this out, so I was like, holy fucking, I gotta make a video about this. It's really impressive, and I think that Microsoft has to take point and take note of what Sony's doing. I'm not a Sony fanboy. I'm not a Microsoft fanboy, obviously. I'm not even a PC fanboy. Whatever platform you want to play on, that's a platform for you. And whatever platform your friends are on, that's a platform for you. That's perfect for you, because you make it perfect for you if you enjoy what you're doing. I just play Dark Souls on the PS3 because I like the PS3 controller more for third-person action RPGs. That's actually the only thing I think the PS3's controller is actually good for, is action RPGs. And that's why I play it. The Xbox controller is probably one of the best ones for sports and racing games. And obviously for, you know, first-person shooters, we use a keyboard and mouse because we like our accuracy. Anyways, take care.